You've heard people talk about this place called Sebastopol, but you want to know more. And there's a lot to know. Like, for instance, did you know that the original name Sebastopol is actually a French word, Sébastopol, which actually means stuck behind a Prius? True story. So yeah, we're going to go over this and a whole lot more. Stay tuned. Alright, you're here because you want to know what it's like to eat, sleep, live, play here in Sonoma County. So, in order to get you that content, do me a favor, hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell so we can make sure to get you that content on what it's like to live here in wine country. Okay, so here's the top three things that you're really going to need to know before coming out to Sebastopol. So number one, diverse landscapes. Now what I mean by that is that if you want the flatlands, you want the vineyards, you can find that. You want more of that coastal feel, you can find that. You want more of a redwood forest, kind of that fairy tale landscape, yeah, you can totally find that too. Downtown, totally different, but yes, you've got a lot of different various landscapes, and it really depends on what exactly you're looking for. So really identify what's important to you and then make sure you're relaying it to your agent so we can kind of make sure that you're looking in the right area, because it is a little interesting that one little place can have this much going for it. All right, number two, permitting and septic. So Sebastopol used to be the wild, wild west, which means there are gonna be instances where you walk on a property and you're gonna see a pavilion and a granny unit and all these cool different structures. But it's not until you do that further research that you realize none of that was permitted. So that's something that you really need to understand, understand the process to get permitted, and also understand your own personal feelings regarding that, whether it's something you wanna take on and navigate through the Permits and Resource Management Division here in Sonoma County. The second half of that is going to be septic. Now, when you have properties that are on septic, and we get a lot of people who come from the city that go, what does that mean? Well, we'll talk about that in another video, perhaps. What it means with septic is you are basically determined by bedrooms. So let's say that you have a three-bedroom house, you've got a septic system, you want to add a granny unit. You're going to use all three bedrooms. Well, there's nothing you can do. You can't really move things around. But let's say that you have a four-bedroom septic, and you want to put a one-bedroom granny, you can remove one bedroom, but technically what you're going to do is you're going to remove the closet in one of the rooms, make that an office, and then maybe sit there and talk to the county if you are in the zoning where it can qualify, where now all of a sudden you go ahead and you have the one-bedroom outside, so not the one-bedroom granny and the three-bedroom inside, still utilizing the four-bedroom septic. That said, septic regulations are increasing, it's becoming more difficult. So it's something that you really, really, truly need to understand if you're going to go down that road of owning a country property here in Sonoma County, and especially Sebastopol. Number three, microclimates. Now, what I mean by that is that Sebastopol is not that big, but you've got a few different weather patterns that are happening because of the natural geography of the area. So Sebasta Rosa, which is gonna be West Santa Rosa, also kind of going into that eastern part of Sebastopol, that's gonna kind of creep out towards the Barlow area. That whole area right there, it's kind of the banana belt. You're gonna get warmer climate, you're gonna get less wind, you're still gonna get fog, but the fog's gonna burn off pretty easily. You start going south down on 116, you can head into wind tunnels. You go out on Burnside, it's gonna be a little different. Green Valley Road, a little different. So for you, it's really trying to identify what is the area that you really are interested in. What's the weather pattern you're searching for? And on top of that, making sure that you are visiting that place, that property, in the morning, in the evening, on a weekend. Like, find different areas so you're kind of seeing the fluctuations of that property. It's gonna give you the best idea on what to expect going forward. So there you have it, your top three things you need to remember before moving or checking out Sebastopol. And remember, when you're going through downtown, if you happen to make it all the way through and you didn't see a Prius, that's a special moment. That's when an angel gets his wings. So, with that said, have an amazing time. If you have questions, reach out to us. Take care. Bye.